Well, the FBI has done it again. Hallelujah, FBI. They stopped another bomb plot from the FBI. No, I'm not kidding. I mean, this is getting a little ridiculous. This is dated February 8th, so earlier this week. The arraignment or the bail hearing for the targeted gentleman will be... Actually, it was yesterday. But here it is, okay? Let's break this down. The FBI stops a bomb plot in Oakland, California, which was going to be targeting a Bank of America branch. The plan, however, was plotted by the FBI. The explosive device was provided by the FBI. The vehicle and other instruments needed were all provided by the FBI. The idea was provided by the FBI. The plan was provided by the FBI. And hallelujah, they arrested the bad guy, Aaron Lanza. I'm not saying, let's just clear this up and kind of be mature about this conversation, because I'm not saying that this Aaron Lanza guy is an innocent saint, you know. I mean, obviously, if he's willing to go along with something like this, hello. But he, from all accounts, is a mentally challenged individual. And the idea behind the bomb plot was to... He believed he was working with a network of Al-Qaeda-linked organizations, and he was going to blow up the Bank of America in Oakland, and that would cause the right wing of this country to engage in civil war. At least that was the plot dreamed up by the FBI and Adam Lanza. And, of course, the FBI gets to step in and say, hey, we stopped the bomb. Here's the alarming thing to me. Why are they always stopping their own plots? Not that I think they should let their plot continue and blow something up. That's not it at all. But if there's all these bombs that are constantly being thwarted by the FBI, and we find out that all of them, the New York City Times Square bomber, oh, well, the bomb was provided by the FBI. The idea was provided by the FBI. The van, provided by the FBI. The money, oh, provided by the FBI. The only thing, oh, well, even the bad guy, provided by the FBI. If there was this level of terrorist threat in this country, we would have bombs going off that the FBI didn't catch. Oh, that's right. Didn't think about that. Now, does that mean the FBI, now that I've said it, the FBI has to let one slip through just so they can say, hey, we're relevant? I don't know. But the point is, I'm getting sick and tired of the FBI busting the FBI every time the FBI comes up with a terror plot dreamed up by the FBI. I mean, I'm not trying to be a Debbie Downer to the FBI, and I'm not trying to make light of this situation either. This is a serious threat. But come on. What is it? The last 7 out of 7 have all been FBI plots dreamt up, funded, and executed by the FBI. There comes a point where you say, wait a second. You're not solving the problem. You are the problem. Just irritates me. The New American had a take on this. This is what their article says. Following a series of similar, widely ridiculed so-called sting operations, the Federal Bureau of Investigation announced last week that it had foiled yet another terror plot that, like virtually every other supposed terror plot in recent years, was created, managed, and formed from start to finish by the FBI itself. Hallelujah. They said the same thing we've been saying. Now, you can actually go into the archives. We've been pointing this out since day one when the FBI started busting themselves. This time, the dupe was a 28-year-old California man, Matthew Aaron Lanza, with a documented history of mental illness. So are the FBI targeting the mentally ill? Who apparently believed his government handlers were helping him wage jihad. Critics, however, say the whole scheme smacks of entrapment and a waste of taxpayer money. Well, I can guarantee you it smacks of a waste of taxpayer money. Lanza was arrested by federal agents on February 7th in Oakland after he supposedly tried to blow up a bogus bomb the FBI helped him create. According to authorities, the mentally ill San Jose suspect planned on detonating the fake explosive outside a Bank of America branch. The alleged plan, officials said, was the start of a civil war by making it appear as if the attack had been carried out by anti-government militias, sparking a crackdown by the government of right-wing or right-of-center dissidents. Unbeknownst to Lanza, the explosive device that he allegedly attempted to use had been rendered inoperable by law enforcement, which provided him the thing, and possessed no threat to the public, an FBI admitted in a press release celebrating their arrest of the mentally unstable stooge. The man was charged with an attempted use of a weapon of mass destruction against property used in an activity that affects interstate, and foreign commerce. If convicted, he could face life in prison. Now, here's the million-dollar question. Was Adam Lanza planning on doing this before the FBI talked him into it? This isn't a situation where we're getting an undercover agent inside the bank robbery unit. And, you know, this unit of bank robbers have been terrorizing the West Coast wearing presidential masks. And now we have Keanu Reeves inside. No, that's not what this is. And I understand the importance of undercover work. But what all these plots seem to be, their MO, they seem to find somebody who is vocally unhappy with the government and then talk them into becoming a terrorist. Talk about irresponsible, terrible law enforcement, terrible protection of the United States, terrible respect for the Constitution, terrible manhood, womanhood. How dare you? How dare you think it's okay to wear the badge of an FBI agent if you act like this, endangering Americans? Well, Americans were never in danger. The bomb wasn't going to... Shut up. That's not the point. The point is you're endangering Americans by endangering America. And when you continue to plot these fake bomb plots and then bust them yourself, you're actually laying the foundation for a much larger problem. And I don't want to name that because it's the name that shall not be named, right, FBI? But you know exactly what you're doing. You know what you're doing. You're creating the hatred. So how many bomb plots have the FBI really saved us from? The answer is none. Zero. Zip, zilch, nada. Nine. Niet. But yet, it's a great, great reason to increase funding. I'll bet you dollars to donuts that we increase funding due to stopping and thwarting terrorist attacks. The real terrorists, the real bad guys of the world, just have to be laughing at us. I mean, they really do. They just have to be thinking, man, they are destroying this nation from within, and we don't have to fire a shot. Third world countries have a stronger pillar of existence than this one does at this moment. We are giving up our own freedom. We're giving up our privacy. We're giving up 9 out of the 10 pillars of the Bill of Rights, for goodness sakes, all because we're conducting a war on terrorism. Well, terrorism isn't defined by anybody, nowhere. Matter of fact, the White House even admitted recently, yeah, we really don't know. No, not a clue. Matter of fact, we're just going to let any high-ranking official in my administration make a judgment call. Should that American citizen die? Sure, why not? We are being eroded, eaten away, attacked from within. And when the FBI engages in ludicrous, immature, childish, endangering behavior like this, it amplifies and accelerates that internal destruction. Now, either the FBI agents are too stupid to realize that, or they realize and don't care because, man, this is a really cool job and I get to have that little tiny badge. Going to make a joke there at the FBI's expense, but I think I'll let it slide. But that's where we find ourselves. We find ourselves in a nation that's being destroyed from within from the very people who are sworn to protect it. And it's not just the FBI. This is just an exclamation point. But we have it from the top right on down. When the Bill of Rights fails people, when it starts to falter, which, newsflash, it's not conspiracy theory, it's not, well, maybe someday it looks as if it's being attacked. It's been attacked. There have been violations of 9 of the 10 already. Stop thinking this is, oh, well, this is just a laughing matter, or, oh, this is something that happened once or twice. Destruction only happens once. It's not something that has to be repetitive. We have this mindset, well, unless I see this happening every day on the news, which if you paid attention, you would. But unless I see it every day, well, then it's really not a threat. It's just an anomaly. It's growing pains of having a large nation. Simply not the fact. It's not the truth. Truth is, as we enter the weekend, we are facing a nation that is being systematically destroyed. It's being dismantled. And the saddest part about that is it's being dismantled by people who are intentionally doing it or are just as stupid as the dupes that they claim to keep catching. Don't celebrate your ignorance, FBI. Don't celebrate your incompetence, FBI. Because you're letting all of us down. Man up, woman up, do the right thing. All right, that does it for today, my friends. Today, tomorrow, and as always, may your path lead to heaven, and may freedom follow in your footsteps.